Now, another thing happened the day before yesterday. And it's one of the big processes that's going on. It started in the UPA. It's going to have gigantic implications. The Modi government has wound up the National Crime Records Bureau. NCRB has been shut down, merged into something called, something which I'd never heard of, I don't know, Bureau of Police Research, or I don't even know the name. The NCRB was the most important source of data on 100 things, not just farm suicides. Okay? On rape, on murder, on killings, on everything, on farm suicides, on female suicides, on you name it. The National Crime Records Bureau has been merged into BPPR. I think that will happen within the next month. They've announced that they're going to do it. The Times had a story on this thing. There's a reason why the NCRB had to be destroyed. 2015, the Modi government destroyed the National Nutrition Monitoring Bureau, the only body in this country that kept longitudinal data, long series data which you could compare over very big periods of time. And indeed, the last report they did, offending the UPA government, showed that most rural people were consuming 513 calories less, yeah, so many grams of magnesium less, so many grams of vitamin A less. This is the last survey of the National Nutritional Monitoring Bureau. The results were shocking, and the government responded by shutting down the bureau. So the National Nutrition Monitoring Bureau is gone. The National Crime Records Bureau is gone. You're looking at 25 years, not just this guy, not just the NDA. The NDA does it more blatantly, brings that personalized nastiness to everything they do. Yeah. But this started well under the UPA regime, the destruction of Indian data. It started already, was advanced when Montek Singh ordered the redoing of the NSS of 2009-10. Said it was conducted in a bad year, in a drought year. So reconduct it so that it would show less negative stuff about poverty. So they had to redo it. All your surveys are now being outsourced. So where a government body used 10,000 to 20,000 people to cover a large survey, it will now be done by 3,000, 4,000 people. This has been going on for quite some time. So you're looking at one of the great processes of our time for journalists and reporters to be aware of. You're looking at the complete destruction of the integrity of any data process in this country. 2 minutes on why it is important in one example, farmers' suicides. And I can tell you this, that so many progressives, so many leftists are taken in by the kind of crap that has been put out in the NCRB in the last 2 years. Why is the NCRB different from other bodies? It had a balance of disinterested civilian and disinterested police. Why is the NCRB data, you know, every day when you read about farm suicides in Maharashtra or somewhere, do you know whose data you're reading? Not the NCRB's. For the last 10 years, for the last 5-6 years, you've not been reading NCRB data. That is the state government's revenue department data. There are three kinds of data on the farm suicides. One is the CM's office having to produce an answer in the assembly says, kuch to likho, and they will put some number there, which would be absurd. I once published 4 different estimates of farm suicides made in the same week in Maharashtra, varying by just merely 5,200%. Yeah, simultaneously in parliament and in the assembly, the figures were given by the chief minister, the agriculture minister, the union agriculture minister, and the NCRB. The highest estimate was that by the NCRB. Why revenue department? Because they were worried about compensations. The job of farm suicides is not given to the agriculture department. It's not given to that. It's given, counting that is given to the revenue department, which will make damn sure that almost no suicide was due to distress. Because they don't want to pay. All the figures you're reading are revenue department figures. You'll find a huge deviation between, and I'm serious, a lot of progressives simply, I'll come to that thing about progressives and data, you know, especially academics and data. And this is where you guys are important. You know, we are not academics, we are not bound by stupid conventions. Okay, if you find that something is silly, you stand up and say it's silly. My hero in journalism, for me, the first great reporter in history, you know, was someone who said something that was visible. It was the kid who said the emperor is naked. That was the first great journalist in history. Now, everybody else could see that the emperor was naked, but somebody said it, the emperor is starkers. Right? And then it became the vogue. Right? So you have, second is the, so one is the CM's office putting out stuff. One is the revenue department's figures. The third was the NCRB. Why is the NCRB data superior to anyone else? How do farm suicides data come in NCRB? Every police station in the country is filing data. Every police thana in the country, say, let's take the state of Maharashtra, highest number of suicides, more than 65,000. More than 65,000 suicides in 20 years. Every police station in Maharashtra files its data, not just on farmers' suicides, on all crimes, to a body called District Crime Records Bureau. All districts then file their data to a body called State Crime Records Bureau. All states file their data to the National Crime Records Bureau. So any mischief, anything happens, it's happening at the level, it's just too many police stations across the country. Now the NCRB is staffed by people, unko kuch lena dena nahi hai usme. They are statisticians, bureaucrats, technocrats. They're getting the data, they're formatting it, they're collating the data, they're not creating it. Okay? So, and it'll be headed very often by, from 2012-13, they started having it headed by IGs of police, where it used to be IAS officers. So the police element became more pronounced in the NCRB. Then the state government started telling the police that, you know, that people, including me, are creating needless propaganda and thing, and you should start. So from 2012, from 2011, states after state started declaring zero suicides. In 2014 data, 12 states and 6 union territories declared zero farmer suicides, meaning India is paradise on earth for farmers. That is, they don't even have the number of suicides that the rest of society has. They don't even have a fraction of it in those 12 states. As soon as Chhattisgarh started doing it, the next to kick in the same year was Didi. So West Bengal, which had an average of 850 farmers' suicides a year, for the next 4 years had zero. Chhattisgarh, which had an average of 1,555 suicides for 10 years, had zero for the next 5. So numbers will fall. I kept doing the calculations on, suppose I give both calculations, the figures that NCRB gives and what would have happened if we calculate on that average, on the 10-year average. Okay. Then this was still causing them a lot of trouble. So they started playing with the definition of farmer. And this is where a lot of academics and others have been taken in. Yeah. They divide it into farmers, tenant farmers and agricultural laborers. Now the implication is that what you got all along included all these groups. It's not so. It is not so. Those others came in the column called others. Okay? So what happens is, when you say tenant farmers, 85%, what, 85, nonsense, 95% of tenancies in the country are not recorded. Okay? Since 95% of tenancies are not recorded, what does it mean? It means that in India, even a trained researcher or someone with 30 years experience like myself in this, it's very difficult to tell the difference between an agricultural laborer and a tenant farmer. There are no documents. So when the cop goes to the suicide house, the first thing he'll ask the widow is, Patta dikho. In Maharashtra, they'll say, Sat bara dikho. She'll say, what patta? Because the tenancy is done on word of mouth, word of honor. Your family knows my family, I give you 3 acres. I'm not ever going to give you a document. I'm afraid that you will appropriate my land. So look at the hilariousness of it. Suddenly, the country becoming famous for farmers' suicides. In 2014, there are far more agricultural laborer suicides than farmers. And farmers' suicides fall by 50%. Because all your tenant farmers have gone into the agricultural laborers column, which is confirmed to me by the statisticians of the NCRB. But there's another place where the farmers went, the others column. As the farm suicide numbers are falling, the others column is exploding. For the 2014 data out in 2015, celebrated and accepted in EPW articles and elsewhere, farm suicides have fallen by more than half. Yeah, the others column went up for those 5 states. Karnataka, farm suicides fell by 56%. Others column expanded by 245%. For the 5 states accounting for 70% of your suicides, the others column went up by 132%. There's absolutely no precedent to that kind of thing in a others column. There is one, going back to the first farm investigation. So I'm saying data is being destroyed. The integrity of the data process is being destroyed. By making those changes in 14, 15, 16, they made the current data completely incomparable with the past data set. And now we don't know whether it will happen there at all. And by the way, they're talking, since we're in the process of decriminalizing suicide, someone is going to ask the question, why should we maintain suicide data?